Hello everyone, and thank you really much for this opportunity to speak and present my research at this workshop, and a huge thank you to the organizers. My name is Judith Pap. I come from the University of Naples L'Orientale, where I teach Hungarian language and literature. I also apologize for my English. So the title of my presentation is How the COVID-19 Pandemic is Changing the Hungarian Language, Building a Domain-Specific Hungarian-Italian English Glossary of the COVID-19 Pandemic with Sketch Engine and Lexonomy. And to the left, you can see a word cloud which contains just a few examples of the new corona-related Hungarian terms. A part of these terms are neologisms and new multi-word expressions, and others are just terms that with the outbreak of the pandemic have an expansion and an explosion in their frequency. So the aim of this project is to create a corona corpus and a glossary of equivalents, but also to understand how the different waves and phases of the pandemic are changing the Hungarian language, I mean the common language, and also to detect the corona COVID pandemic virus mask quarantine and vaccine related neologisms, and offer an overview of the most frequent and linguistic most interesting Hungarian neologisms and multi-word units related to the pandemic. To the right, you can see the main page of the glossary I've created in Lexonomy. The glossary is public, so you can visit it and make some research, and maybe you can also let me know your impressions. The corpus for the creation of the glossary, I've decided, first of all, to build an own COVID-related Hungarian corpus using Sketch Engine. This decision is due to the fact that, as far as I know, there is no available public COVID-related Hungarian corpus. So part of the coroneologies and the words related to the COVID-19 pandemic are detected in this specific corpus, built using three options of Sketch Engine that make it possible to make the corpus bigger and larger. So I used seed words and URLs and also complete websites. Actually, the corpus has more than 9 million tokens. And below you can see a word cloud containing the main seed words I used to the creation of this corpus. Concerning complete websites, you can see the main websites I decided to download. The first one is coronavirus.gov.hu, which is the governmental portal in Hungarian on the pandemic and on COVID-19. It was created together with the operational force, also operated by the government. A very interesting website is COVID-1001.hu, which is a website operated by a group of medical translators. So they are translating scientific articles into Hungarian, and they are uploading all these articles to this website. I've also downloaded part of the Semmelweis.hu website. Semmelweis is a famous university and hospital located in Budapest. I've also downloaded parts of the Elte.hu website. This is operated by the famous university at Eötvös Loránd of Budapest. I've downloaded part of the Europa2000.hu website. This is a secondary school, secondary grammar school located in Budapest. And finally, Luckily, we have also the Hungarian version of Pfizer.hu, so the Hungarian version of the international website of the company. For the domain-specific terminology extraction, I use the one-click dictionary function of Sketch Engine, and I've created different drafts of the glossary. This is a very useful option to get linguistical data. Also, post-editing is required. So after the creation of different draft dictionaries and the extraction of as many head words as possible, I tried to learn how to use Lexonomy, and I learned how to configure and customize the structure and the formatting of a dictionary. So I prefer to create a new and empty glossary and to insert the data manually. In this case, obviously, the method is time-consuming, but the results are more precise and professional. I've also configured the connection with my Sketch Engine account, so I can implement examples, for example, or collocations from the corpora I'm using. And below you can see the address of the glossary. So you can just take a note of it and visit the page. But my specialized corpus is not the unique source I use for the creation of the glossary and the implementation of the glossary. As you can see, I also use two timestamped web corpora created by the Josef Stefan Institute in Ljubljana. These corpora contains news articles. So these are important to detect corona-related terms in standard Hungarian language, while my corona corpus is useful to detect coronologies and occasionalies also in other type and other kind of websites, such as I illustrated. So we have represented also government websites, home pages, school and university websites, blogs, and social networks too. And in this way, colloquial language and formal language are also represented in the glossary. In particular, the two timestamped web corpora are an outstanding tool to detect also the behavior of the words or the single word forms. Trends in particular is a very important and interesting feature of Sketch Engine for detecting words which undergo change in the frequency. And this is very, very important for the period of the pandemic. And to be able to extract the pandemic-related terms with my corpus and with the two web corpora, I used the keyword and the word list and concordance functions of Sketch Engine. And in word list, using the basic tab, I also search for certain strings such as COVID, corona, Karan, which is the first part of the word quarantine. And I use I have to use Karan because quarantine sometimes became abbreviated in fusion words, for example. And I searched also for járvány, pandemic, virus, fert, which is the first part of the Hungarian word fert, to infect, or beteg, véd, old, vakcina, and also immune. So in this way, I have also the productivity of these corresponding lemmas. This is just the process I'm following for the implementation of the glossary. So I have the three corpora. There is a phase for the extraction, for the terminology extraction, a post-editing phase, which is necessary for Hungarian, and then the implementation of the glossary. This is just an example. The entry here is Yarvány, which means epidemic in English. And as you can see, I'm trying to implement the glossary with different type of information. There are different fields, such as definition, word formation process, temporal use, register, subject field, and style or etymology. And obviously, I have more open fields, such as the notes. And then you can see a certain number of examples taken from the corpora. Below, you can find the section dedicated to the Italian language and then to the English language. Also here we have the equivalents and examples taken from the web. And hopefully I'll be able to add also other type of information. A concrete particular example that I'd like to show you concerns the Hungarian word mask. So if we analyze dictionaries, we discover that this word can mean different type of objects or phenomenons. So mask can be used in Hungarian for theater masks, or for face masks, or surgical mask, gas mask, anesthetical mask, but also, and maybe this is the most frequent usage in common language, it refers to burglar's mask, or as you can see, to actors who mask themselves to interpret a certain person or personage. But obviously with the pandemic, the usage of this word is exploded, mostly during the second wave of the pandemic, because the emphasis was on the importance of wearing face mask. So mask viselés is the compound word in Hungarian for it. And before the pandemic, if we analyze the corpora, we can find that this word was represented only a minimal proportion in common language, and usually with this meaning, so the object that serves for covering someone's face to hide his or her identity. With the pandemic, so the productivity of this word is exploded. Now we have mask, simple mask, or eye mask, mouth mask, or arts mask, face mask. And we have in a small proportion also arts pies, which means a face shield. This last one is not so widespread because the object, the face shield, is not so common in Hungary. So now mask usually refers to these objects, to the surgical mask and to the other type of protective masks. And this is a very interesting chart that shows you the distribution of this word in the Hungarian corpus. You can see that the frequency of the word is exploded starting from March 2020. And during last year, it has different peaks, but it is very, very widespread during these different waves. And as I said, the word mask is very productive right now. In the corpus or in the corpora, we have more than 200 mask-related neologisms. So one is obviously mask, and then we have only 8 derivations and 2 blend words, and the remaining part are all compound words. The blend words are maskne and maskitis, both entered in the Hungarian language from English. We have arany mask, gold mask, which is an occasionalism. It refers to the story of an Indian businessman who bought for himself a customized gold mask. And an interesting example is Okos mask. I think it was introduced in Japan first, a smart mask. And in Hungarian, it follows the example of okos telefon, okos eszköz, okos szemüveg, okos óra. So with the element okos, which means smart, such as in smartphone, smart device, smart glasses, or smart watch. Here you have a word cloud that contains all these new creations. Also in Hungarian, we have many indecisions concerning the spelling with or without hyphens, one words, two words. So I know that there are also researches, ongoing researches concerning spelling and orthography in particular. And in this slide, you can see the derivated forms. Usually these are adjectives, but we have also maszkosodunk, which is very interesting. Literally, it means we are getting masked. And we have also a kind of abstract noun, maszkosság, which may be could be translated with maskity. This is a word to describe the phenomenon, the necessity of wearing masks. Conclusions, the analysis performed on the glossary would suggest that the most frequently occurring word formation processes of the Hungarian neologisms are compoundings, syntax, blendings, derivations, and semantic extensions. And at the end of the pandemic, it will also reveal to what extent the Hungarian language borrows coroneologisms or coroneologisms from other languages, first of all, obviously, from English. Time passes, but the impact of the pandemic is still strong. Still now, we see the creation of new terms. In these last phases, we have many, many new terms related to vaccine and obviously to the certification, such as green pass or COVID passport or something similar. And so the corpus-based glossary will be a valuable tool to explore and analyze the Hungarian press language and corona lexicon during this emergency. And I hope it will be also useful for linguists and translators and also for scholars just working in digital humanities. Thank you very much for your attention.